Hi everybody, welcome to our channel Remember Boy. The Nets made a stunning move Thursday to fill their coaching vacancy by hiring Steve Nash, the Hall of Fame point guard and two-time NBA Most Valuable Player award winner, despite Nash's lack of coaching experience. Nash will replace, who will stay on as an assistant. Mutually agreed to part ways with Kenny Atkinson, despite missing most of his frontline players, spot from Caris LeVert and Joey Harris. Wagan coached the Nets to 5-3 record in the 8th seeding games at the NBA restart. The Nets were then swept in the first round by the Toronto Raptors, the reigning champions, but surprised many with a victory over Milwaukee and a 1-point loss to Portland that nearly prevented the Trail Blazers from reaching the playoff. Wagan became the fourth head coach and third black head coach alongside New Orleans' Alvin Gentry and Indians' Nat McMillan to lose his job after his team returned home from the NBA bubble and Walt Disney World. Philadelphia also fired coach Brett Brown after a first-round sweep against Boston. The Nets have maintained since March that Wagan would be considered strongly for the full-time post. They were also widely expected to pursue Tyron Lue, the Los Angeles Clippers in-demand assistant coach, among a number of other experienced candidates. Lue coached the Nets star guard Kyrie Irving to a championship with the Cleveland Cavaliers in 2006, yet Marks had quickly targeted Nash for some time, according to three people familiar with the search who were not authorized to discuss it publicly. Marks' interest stemmed in part from Nash's strong bond with Durant, with the bolt across Durant's dear season in Golden State will working as a part-time consultant for the Warriors in player development. The more immediate challenge for Nash will be establishing a similar rapport with Irving riddled debut season in Brooklyn. Durant sat the season out entirely as he recovered from a torn right Achilles tendon he sustained during the 2019 NBA Finals. He continues to be a very loud voice in terms of where we're going in the future and what we're doing, and involve him like the other players and staff, and how we'll continue to build this team and how we move forward, Mark said of Durant in early July. Nash, 46, arrived in Brooklyn this week, according to the People, an 8-time All-Star who led the league in assists five times. Nash had resisted all previous offers to join an NBA coaching staff full-time, even as an assistant, since retiring after the 2013-14 season, saying repeatedly that he intended to put his coaching and front office aspirations on hold until his five children were older. The Phoenix Suns, with whom Nash won his back-to-back MVP award in 2005 and 2006, gagged Nash's interest in recent years in both coaching and front office work. Marks thought convinced Nash to move up his timetable and make an immediate leap to head coaching, similar to what the Nets' previous regime did in June 2013 when they hired Jason Kidd, one of Nash's playing contemporaries, just after Kidd had participated in the playoffs with the Knicks. Hearing beyond the questions sure to be raised about Nash's lack of experience will also bring renewed attention to the league's dwindling number of black head coaches. Wagan's reassignment has left the NBA with just five in a league in which the player pool is estimated to be roughly 18% black. At the start of the 2012-2013 season, there were four black head coaches. New Orleans and Indiana have yet to replace Gentry and McMillan. Philadelphia and Chicago are the NBA's other two teams with a coaching vacancy. The other current black coaches are Atlanta's Leon Pierce, Cleveland's GB Bickerstaff, Detroit's Devon Casey, Phoenix's Monty Williams, and the Los Angeles Clippers' Doc Rivers. Charlotte's James Borrego was the first Latino coach in NBA history, and Miami's Eric Spoelstra, Filipino descent, was the league's first Asian American coach. In retirement, Nash has worked with the men's senior national basketball team in his native Canada, both as the program's general manager and in an advisory role, while maintaining a significant presence in soccer as both a team owner and broadcaster. For the past two seasons, Nash was Turner Sport coverage of the Champions League. The various soccer jobs, Nash has said, allowed him to be home with his children in the Los Angeles area. So guys, you must have liked the video. See you in the next video with new updates. Goodbye.